For that, first we will create a virtual environment, because it is a good practice that we create a virtual environment for each separate Python project. So we will also create virtual environment first, and then inside that environment we will install KV package. So for that, the Python should be installed in your machine, and to check whether it is installed or not, you can run this particular command on a terminal. So you can run python 3 space hyphen hyphen version. So if you also get this type of output, it means the Python is installed in your machine. Otherwise, you can refer another video which I have already created on this channel itself, and the link of that video you would find in the description below. I have explained the steps to install Python in a very easy manner in that video. Let's now proceed to create the virtual environment first. So for that, I would move to the directory where I want to create the virtual environment. So for this video, I would move to the downloads folder first. So I would say cd and downloads. So here I would create the virtual environment using particular command, which is python 3 space minus m and venv. Then I would give the name of the virtual environment which I want to create. So I would say kv underscore install, and it would create the virtual environment with this name, which is kv underscore install. And it has also created one folder as well in my downloads directory. So let me show you that also. So if I go to the downloads folder, then you would see this kv underscore install directory here, and inside that these folders and file are also present. Now we will have to activate this particular environment in order to install the kv library inside that. So for that, we will have to source one file which is present inside this bin directory. So let me show you that also. So if I open up this, so you would see this activate file. So we will have to source this activate file in our terminal. So I would say source, and I would need to give the path of that activate file. So I would say source and kv underscore install. Then I would say inside the bin directory, it is present the activate file. As you can see, kv underscore install is written in the beginning of this particular line. So it means this particular environment is activated now. Let's now go ahead and install the kv library using pip. So we would use pip here, and I would say pip install kv, and I would hit enter now. Now the installation has begun, and it has installed the kv library successfully. As you can see here, successfully installed. So it means the kv is installed successfully. Let's now see whether it is installed properly or not. So I would list down all the packages which are installed in particular environment, which is this kv install. So I would say pip list. So this will list down all the libraries and packages. Here we have to look for this kv library. So here you can see kv is present, and the version of kv is 2.3.0. So it means the kv is installed in this activated environment. Let me clear the screen first, and now we will try to use this kv library in a Python shell. So I will open up the Python shell using python 3 command, and now I would try to import the kv. Import space kv. I would hit enter. So as you can see, we did not get any error here. So it means the kv is imported successfully. Let's now print the version of kv. So I would say kv dot underscore underscore version and underscore underscore, and I would hit enter now. So as you can see, the version is same what we had seen here when we have listed down using the pip list command. So kv, it was 2.3.0, and here also the version is same. So we can say the kv is installed properly. So that's all for this video.